What's up and welcome back to my channel. It feels like it's a good day to film. I am always nervous because when it rains, it gets really dark and gloomy. So it's nice and sunny today. So I was really confused of what I want to put out on my channel because look, we can't go out. I can't do any traveling vlogs. I don't have shoots, meetings, nothing. So I'm basically at home like going crazy as to what do you guys want to see on YouTube, okay? And I realized that a lot of you still want to see beginner's makeup, drugstore products, like it's still going on because I get a fresh load of subscribers every time and they don't know where to find my old videos. So I'm going to update the beginner's makeup as well as show you everything that's out there in the drugstore that I personally like, okay? So I pulled out everything from my vanity and I was just going through what do I have that is drugstore. And when I say drugstore, I mean like more of an inexpensive product, okay? That's what I mean when I say drugstore. I'm very used to saying drugstore for inexpensive products. So it doesn't mean that you get it in a drugstore, okay? So all these products I either got as PR or I got it on Nykaa or Amazon. Like either of these websites, you will get all of this. So the products that I chose today are moderately priced. So they're not too cheap, okay? And they're not too expensive. It's something you can afford. It's inexpensive. It's accessible. It's ranging from 200 rupees all the way to 1500. I don't think I crossed 1500. I'm not sure. But yeah, I pulled out whatever I thought that I would use if I was using drugstore products. So I have more than one product in each category and I want to show you that you have options in the drugstore. You can choose this or this depending on your choice. So please make an informed decision. I'm going to tell you all that I can about these products. So it's going to be a long video and I'm also going to do the makeup and put it on my face so you can see how it looks. Okay. So it's all up to you to decide if you want to purchase it or not. But for me, I feel like all these products are good quality and they're affordable. So I personally don't like to use products like Miss Claire and things like that are very, very cheap, like 50 rupees an eyeliner. Like I don't believe in using that anymore. I used to in the beginning when I started out, but I feel like if you are someone who wants to start a makeup channel or someone who just wants to use good quality products so that your face doesn't break out and you know, you get your money's worth, I think these are the products to go for. Okay, so don't try and choose the cheapest makeup product in the store or online because you don't know what they're putting in your products. You guys go for trusted brands, go for brands that people have been using for a long time and you know that it's not going to affect your skin. So investing a little bit more in your makeup and making that your essentials kit. Okay, so now that we're up close and personal, we're gonna dive into the video. I already put some moisturizer in the morning and I put on some lipstick. Okay, my lips are rosy but it's not this rosy, so I like to put on a dab of like any lip cream or something just so it's hydrated before I put on lipstick. Okay, so for face, I have two moisturizers here. I have the Pond's Light Moisturizer Non-Oily Fresh Feel for soft and glowing skin. It has vitamin E and glycerin and this is the one right here. And then I have the Pond's Super Light Gel Oil-Free Moisturizer for non-sticky glowing skin. It has hyaluronic acid and vitamin E. So this is the product I have over here. And this was sent to me in PR, you guys, long back. Now, having read the details of these products, they both can be used all around the year and they both can be used for all skin types, okay? So there's not necessarily any properties specific to a skin type. For me, I think I'm going to use half and half just for fun. I tried this on my arm and it was more like a gel form and this is more a cream form. So let me show you. Okay, so can you see this cream is more on the white thick cream side and this blue one smells beautiful. Firstly, it smells gorgeous. This is how the cream looks. So it's more transparent, translucent, and it's more gel like. Okay, so for my right side, I'm going to use this one, which is a super light moisturizer, and both of these are really inexpensive. It's about like, I don't know, I'm going to leave the prices on the screen or down below so you can check it out and I'm not making any mistake. Oh my god, this smells like my childhood. I'm not joking. Oh my god, this smells so good. Always, always remember to moisturize your skin before going in with your base makeup. It's very important to set a base for your base makeup, okay? You can't just go in on dry skin. That's like the worst you can do. And there's a lot that you get. So for 150 or 200 bucks, that's a lot of moisturizer, okay? So I'm gonna use this for my left side. This is more like my type. Woo! Smells so good. Smells so good. Okay, so seeing both the moisturizers on my face, this definitely feels hydrated still. It doesn't soak up entirely, which is a good feeling because some moisturizers, when I put it, it just like soaks it up and it looks like you've never put moisturizer before. So yeah, I like this side. It's more on the matte side. Still hydrated, but not shiny. This side, however, is more like juicy and, you know, very, you can see it. It's very visible on the skin. It's super light as well. I think this could be bought by people like me who have extremely dry skin. I feel like it's going to give you a little bit of a glow into your dull, dry skin that we dry girls have. All right, so that was a detailed description of moisturizers. That's how detailed this video is going to be, okay? Because we're going all in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a little bit of this blue one because I like it and I'm just going to apply it on the right side as well. Okay, now that our skin is hydrated, I love the way it looks. It feels good, super light. It's not heavy or oily or sticky. It's a beautiful plump skin. Loving the blue moisturizer actually more. It just feels so good. Okay, so the next step would be your primer, okay? It's very, very important to use a primer, you guys, because it sort of fills in your pores. If you have enlarged pores here because of acne or just aging, it'll sort of bridge the gap between your foundation and your skin. So it's a great thing to use a primer. I used to not use primers at all and I thought it didn't make any difference, but it makes so much difference, okay? So definitely I use it around my nose area and also depending on what problem you're tackling. So first is the NYX Professional Makeup Can't Stop, Won't Stop Matte Primer. Okay, this is the one right here. Okay, so when it says matte primer, girls with oily skin, this is for you, okay? So this mattifies your skin. So if you've got oily skin, it can completely balance out the oil and it'll give you a beautiful finish on your makeup. Now, I have another one by NYX. I think I have only NYX primers and I have Colourbar as well, but I chose this because I use this more often. This is the NYX Pore Filler Primer Base. So this is meant for any skin type, okay? It's a pore filling primer. So the gaps you see with the acne scars and stuff you have, it's gonna bridge the gap when you tap it into your skin. So I'm going to use the pore filler primer because I know it's what I use most of the time. I don't want to mattify my skin, so I'm not going to go in with this primer because I want a glowy skin, okay? I'm going to go in and press the pore filling primer into my skin, into my nose, okay? It gives you a really, really blurred out effect. The primer is used for pore filling and it'll allow your makeup to last longer. Some primers give you a tacky finish, so it helps your foundation stick. So all of these steps are very, very necessary before you jump into foundation directly, okay? Okay, so when it comes to foundation, all of us are very, very particular on what we put on our face. We find a foundation and we stick to it for life. I feel like that's what we do. Now I'm sticking to the Smashbox foundation a lot because I love the finish, but we're not talking about high-end here. We're talking about drugstore and slightly inexpensive makeup. So for foundation, I've rounded up to these foundations. So, the first foundation is the Nykaa Skin Shield Foundation. This has, it's anti-pollution, deep hydration, oil control. This is a great foundation. It's a great foundation. I am the shade 7 Hot Honey. Unfortunately, the shade range is not that good. I was actually very disappointed in the shade range, but the formulation and the coverage is outstanding. And that's why I just had to recommend it even though the shade range is not that good. Okay, so the next foundation I chose is also like in my top three. It is beautiful. It's the NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation. Again, you can use this for all skin types simply because it's got a demi matte finish. It's, so it's dewy, it's also matte. It's like a beautiful, beautiful finish on the skin. Doesn't dry out your skin. I'm in the shade Medium Olive in the Can't Stop, Won't Stop. And I think they have shades in this, I'm not sure, but if you cannot find your shade online, I highly recommend that you wait till the stores open up and then you go do like a swatch testing. That's the only way you can find your shade, you guys. All right, so the next foundation I have, this is specifically for my girls with oily skin, not for dry skin. I don't recommend this for dry skin types, but it is such a beautiful foundation. It's the L'Oreal Paris 24 Hour Infallible Pro Matte Foundation. This is the one. It's just recently launched and it's very, very beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, it gives you a full bloody coverage. It's so good that I am tempted to use it sometimes. But for my oily skin girls, look no further. It's a beautiful foundation. And I'm confused with my shade actually. On some days I'm 104 golden beige and on some days I'm 106 sun beige. So these are like really warm tones, so I can shuffle between the two. Then we have the one and only, I'm sure you guys know what I'm about to say. It's the Maybelline Matte and Poreless Fit Me Foundation. This is normal to oily skin, so even dry skin can use this. Oily skin, normal skin, all skin types, okay? So that's what I love about this foundation, and I've been using it ever since the beginning of my channel, and I still have this and I still continue to get it because it's one foundation that it will not fail you no matter what. It's one of those safest go-to foundation, which is very inexpensive. It's very good quality and it's got like a light to medium coverage. Okay, it's not the most full coverage foundation. So if you do have a lot of scars and acne and things like that, I don't recommend this for you because it's not going to cover those scars and stuff for you. But if you do want coverage, this is the one to go to, and the NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop. So for now, I'm going to mix a few foundations because suddenly I pulled all of them out and now I'm intrigued. So I'm going to mix the Nykaa Skin Shield and the Maybelline Fit Me. I'm also doing sort of a beginner's makeup, okay? So watch out for the makeup as well while I'm talking about the products. Whenever you're starting with your base makeup, you always want to put very little and on the most problematic areas you can. So I start out with my cheek and then I blend it all over. Okay, so when it comes to beauty sponges, this is the one I'm using. It's by the drugstore company. I will have it linked down below so you can get it. It is amazing, so soft, and it's just the perfect beauty sponge. And another one I would recommend is the PAC one. The PAC cosmetic sponges are also great. The black one and not the pink and the red. I gravitate towards the black one when it comes to the PAC. Okay, so now I'm taking this drugstore company sponge and I'm just going to start blending my foundation in. I highly recommend you using a beauty sponge and not a brush. I don't know, brush is just not my thing. Yeah, when I'm applying makeup, I can see the strokes of the brush and I don't like it. The sponge just acts like a finger. If you want to use your finger, go ahead. But to get the most flawless finish, this is what you are going to do ideally. It's got a very medium to light coverage. Super light, everyday use, beginners. If you're a person that spends all her day outside, you know, in your office, your college, these are great foundations. And they don't even break the bank, which is great. Spend time pushing the foundation in, okay? Just that's what the beauty sponge does. That's why I love it so much. And very, very less foundation on the forehead. Very less. Okay, you do not want to apply a lot of foundation because that's when it gets tricky. Because we make a lot of expression like in the day, and our forehead lines, because we don't have Botox for now, our forehead lines are very, very visible. So when we sweat or when we make a lot of expressions, our foundation gets settled into those lines. So try and not putting a lot of foundation there. Try and avoiding that area, but just touch it up a little. It's gonna go over. Don't forget the crevice around your nose. If you're getting ready with me, do it with me. Around the mouth, we have darkness around the mouth, so make sure you're covering that. Also for the summers, a tip that I would like to give you is don't put foundation on your stash area, girls, because we swept there first thing and all your foundation comes out, right? So whatever's remaining, you just want to tap it. That's it. Like, don't actually put foundation under your lip. Because we do these mistakes so often and then we're like, why did this happen? We don't know what we're doing wrong. So after a lot of careful observation, I've realized what I should and should not do. Okay, so less makeup on the forehead, almost no makeup on the stash area. You only want to get a brush and just blend it so it looks similar and not like separate. So happy with the coverage. I'm so happy. It's very, very medium and juicy. Okay, so of course, if you want to go down your neck, you can, but I don't like putting makeup on my neck. Just a little bit. Alright, so next is concealer. This is also a big controversy because we're like, which concealer is the best concealer out there? And there's so many options, you guys. I totally get you. And to choose a concealer shade online is very difficult because the picture is something else, the shade swatch is something else, and when you get it in your hand, you're like, no, this is not what I ordered, ma'am, please. So again, if you want to test your concealer, go to a store and test your concealer. Or you can watch a YouTuber that is very similar to your skin tone and then buy the exact shade. That's what I do if I don't want to go to a store. I Google all my favorite YouTubers and I see who's closest to my skin type. That's the concealer I will buy. That's a little bit of research. You have to put in some effort. You can't be spoon-fed, guys. Come on. do some research. Okay, so for concealer, I have four concealers that I pulled out. I'm gonna go one by one and talk to you about them. So the first one I'm pulling up is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. I'm in the shade Sand or Medium. Really depends. There are enough shades you can choose from, but this is a concealer I really like because it really acts like an eraser, and it's one of those concealers that is heavy duty and slightly drying. It can be drying but not very scary. Don't worry, I've used this a couple of times. So great to conceal heavy marks on your face. If you've got an acne spot that just would not quit and you're like, Maz, the foundation is not covering it, this is what will cover it. It's an eraser, so it'll leave like a very, very heavy coverage on your face, and that's why I call it like a heavy duty concealer, because it does erase and cover your face fully. So the next is the L'Oreal Paris Infallible Full Wear Concealer. This is in the shade Amber 312. Okay, this is my shade. Okay, I have been loving this concealer. I'm sure you've seen me use this a lot. This is also a very full coverage concealer. I love this concealer actually, and it's great. Again, slightly drying. And when I say slightly drying, I don't have a problem using it. I'm a dry skin type, but I will use it anyway because of the coverage. It's so good. All you need is one dot and it'll cover your entire dark circle. So find your shade, get this, beautiful. Next concealer is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. This is in the shade Sand Sable. Oh my god, I remember using this. I'm actually the shade medium, and then I go in with Sand Sable to brighten. Okay, so it's like a shade or two lighter than what I usually am. Again, a great concealer, very affordable, very inexpensive, very light to medium coverage. I will not say that this covers your dark circles. It will show through because it's a very everyday wearable light makeup for beginners who don't want that much coverage. This is your concealer. Okay, I personally don't like to use this alone because I want coverage. Okay, and the next concealer is the LA Girl Pro Conceal, which is my number one favorite concealer as of now. It's in the shade Pure Beige. Now this is slightly darker than what I usually am, because, and I choose that because it's got a very orange undertone which will cancel out this darkness that you see. I don't have to talk more about this. It's my number one. I love this. So yeah. So I'm gonna go in with the LA Girl. Of course, so inexpensive also, that's the best part. Okay, so for the makeup bit, very less. Okay, do not go and draw big stripes and triangles. Don't do the blogger method. Okay, I'm all about the wearable makeup. So all you want to do is start pushing the concealer. Okay, see the coverage for yourself. Gone. Okay, so good. And I'm also gonna go over my lid. I'm gonna take a brush. This is the PAC 272 brush. My brush video is also out, you guys. I'm gonna have it linked down below so you can check out the brushes as well. Okay, so now that I have concealed my dark circles, I want to brighten my face. Okay, that's what I personally like doing. If you say, Miles, one concealer is enough, you don't have to do this step. Okay, but for you guys who want to learn how to sculpt and everything, this is what you will do. Okay, I'm gonna take Sand Sable because I pulled it out anyway and it's a lighter shade. Can you see that instant pop, that instant brightness? It's very subtle. Okay, very subtle, but it does something. And of course, if you want to highlight and conceal more, the areas you can apply the concealer are on your chin, on the bridge of your nose, and teensy bit on the forehead. I don't like using forehead makeup, so that's like so little. So, and there you have it, very subtle. Okay, we're not going crazy. I don't like heavy makeup. All right, now next comes the powder. Powder is so important, guys. Do not walk out of your house without setting your face. It's the biggest mistake I did in 2011, I would like to say, when I was in college. Girl, I didn't know nothing, okay? I just put on a full face of foundation like this and I went in the summer heat in Bombay, traveled by BST bus, went to college in Bandra Nationals, and I was just like roaming around like this, and God knows how many people I've hugged and put my foundation on their shirt, God knows. But don't make that mistake, okay? Even if you're a dry skin and oily skin, this step is non-negotiable. It's something you just have to do if you want long-lasting makeup. The powders I'm going to recommend to you are vis-a-vis the following. It's a friend's reference. Okay, for drugstore, I have tried the NYX powders. I have tried a few powders, but I didn't gravitate towards them. It was not my favorite. I have boiled down to these two powders. It is the Maybelline Fit Me, of course. Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder in the shade Light 15. It's a magic powder. It's one of the best powders I've come across in the market, which is affordable and so worth every rupee you're spending on this, okay? It's a good quantity. It's a little bulky, but who cares? It's a great powder and very accessible. 15 has a little bit of a pink shade. It's a pinky undertone, but I'm okay with it. I make it work somehow. The next powder is the K-Beauty powder that recently launched. It is the HD Loose Setting Powder in Banana. So now I'm going to talk to you about the difference between these. Miles, which do I get? So this is more affordable than this. If you want to get, you can get either or. Okay, solely up to you. This has more shade ranges though. This has literally 8 or 12. I'm not sure. A lot of shades, okay? So I'm choosing Banana over here because it's a better powder for me. And even vanilla is really great, but I'll tell you the difference. This is more heavy duty, it's more thicker, and it's got coverage on the powder. This is lighter, very, very finely milled, and it's got lesser coverage in the powder. If you are battling heavy dark circles, you're going to see your dark circles if you set your under eye. So that is a little bit of a drawback of this powder. I've realized after using it a lot, it is not my number one go-to. I would pick this first and then I would pick this, because this does set the face, it does mattify the face. It's actually really great for dry skin because it's not very cakey under the eye. It's a very smooth application. It's good. For this video, I'm going to use both the powders. So you want to take your beauty sponge and get rid of all the creasing. Now you'll take your beauty sponge as is, which was damp, right? And you will dip it into the powder. Bake if you want to bake, otherwise don't bake, just set it. Okay, so I'm baking a little bit and then we'll dust off the powder in a bit. Then I'm gonna take my K-Beauty banana powder. The powder is so light and there's a vast difference between the color. This is so pinky and this is so like yellow because it's banana. Okay, since we're going to go in with powder products, I do want to set the rest of my face. But I've realized that whenever I set the rest of my face with powder earlier, it used to be very cakey and dry. And I'm a dry skin type, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of the K-Beauty powder. And what I'm going to do is just dunk my beauty sponge. And all you will do is push the powder into your makeup. Push it in. And that ensures that you don't have dry, crepey skin. It'll ensure that it looks good. It is mushed in with your foundation and it just looks like skin. That is the trick to having very, very flawless, non-cakey face. So considering my beauty sponge is a little bit damp, it's not reeking with water, no water's coming out, but it's slightly damp. So again, mostly I'm pushing it towards this area because this is where I'm gonna contour with powder products. Okay, next thing we're gonna move on is our brows. Okay, so for brows, I don't have many options at all, in fact. I just have one option. The Nykaa brow products are good, but I'm not like gravitated towards them. I have this, however. This is the NYX Professional Micro Brow Pencil. The reason I kept this still is because it is so thin, you guys. Look at this. It is super, super tiny and it's gonna get right into your brows and create a really good hair-like thing. It's more on the warm side. I typically like cooler tone pencils, so an ash brown or something would be better. But I'm using what I have right now. Okay, so brows are extremely personal, you guys. I like my brows boxy and massive. I know it's not everybody's cup of tea. I like really angular brows and I like big brows, okay? Because that's how my brows are shaped. But you can obviously do it the way you want. So for me to teach you how to do brows is baseless. All right, moving on to eyeshadow palettes. Man, this was complicated. When I was looking through my makeup drawers, I'm just like, all my makeup eyeshadow palettes are not from here. Like I have Anastasia, I've got like Huda Beauty, I have really expensive like Smashbox, all of these, okay? And they're very, very expensive, but beautiful. However, from drugstore, I didn't really find any that I liked. Yeah, I've ordered Makeup Revolution, LA Girl. I've tried to find the right eyeshadow palette, but even the Nykaa eyeshadow palettes, they're good, but they're expensive. They're like $1,500 for 12 eyeshadows. And I'm just like, I don't know, you know, it's really expensive. I narrowed it down to this one, which is also expensive, but I really like. It's the Ultimate Shadow Box by PAC Cosmetics. It's great, guys. It is such a good eyeshadow palette if you're willing to invest in it. So yeah, this is like the rose one. It's very, very pretty. It's got all the colors you would need to create a rose eye. The other one I have for you is by K-Beauty. Okay, these are the eyeshadow sticks they have, which is ranging, I think it's $600. It's 599. Rupees, which I think is affordable as compared to $1,500. Now these are a little bit different. Okay, it's very you have to learn how to work these eyeshadows because they are matte and they have one which is metallic. For beginners, I think this will be really great because you just have one thing that you have to focus on. There's no brushes involved. I'm gonna use this today because it's 600 rupees. Okay, this is in the shade Plush and it's very travel friendly. So if you're the kind of girl who works, this would be it. I'm just gonna put this all over my lid because it's beginner's makeup. I don't want to complicate things. So as you're putting it, you want to work it in quickly. That's what I do. I don't put it and let it rest because it'll set into your eyes really quickly. It's a very beautiful muted rose color. It's really pretty. See guys, the best part is you can work with this using your finger. So no complicated eyeshadow brushes, nothing is needed. Perfect for beginners. That's it. In literally 30 seconds, I got a complete eye. Like, I just have to put mascara and it looks beautiful and very, very wearable. Okay, so I sort of pulled it out a little bit to get a very beautiful cat eye effect. Oh my God, this is like the easiest eyeshadow I have ever done. Like, literally, it's done in under a minute. I've done both my eyes. You have multiple colors in these, okay? That's what I love. You've got great options if you want muted eyes, dramatic eyes. You've got a great black over here, which is in the shade Desire. Then you have metallic ones, which are these, okay? If you're going for a wedding or you want a really good bronzy eye, and you can literally blend it out. Very, very beautiful. It's very nice. It'll give you that red metallic finish, a very nice shimmer eyes, if you will. But for today, we're not gonna do that. We're gonna stay very neutral and basic. Okay, I'm gonna go in with a darker brown, which is Enigma. Okay, and this is the one. You can also order these sharpeners. It's one of those thick pencils. You get it on the website as well. This you'll get on Nykaa as well. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna do a soft liner. Okay, I'm just blending this out. A tiny little shader brush, and all you have to do is push it outside, so it'll give you a very nice smoky light wing. Okay, okay, I'm gonna take a little bit of the blush and I'm gonna put it underneath. Okay, so this is a look I created in like $1,200, and I just want two things in my bag and I don't want to overcomplicate. I don't want a brush to carry everywhere I go. I just want something that I can apply with my fingers and be done with it. Then this is the pencil for you. Okay, this is a good, it's super long lasting. Once it's set, it's set. Okay, so then this is for you. If you're the kind who's like, no, I want to experiment a little more, and if I buy the K-Beauty pencil, it's going to be expensive for me, right? Because each pencil, each color is $600, so it's going to be expensive for you. So if you're the kind of girl who wants to experiment a little more with their eyeshadow, you can invest in a palette like this, which is also small, easy colors to use, and but you need a brush, you need techniques if you want to really master the look. Okay, so moving on to mascara. Okay, this is my favorite bit. So many mascaras I've tried and I've narrowed it down to these two. It's the Maybelline Lash Sensational and the Flower Beauty Lash Warrior. These two are beautiful. This is my go-to. It's empty and it's out of stock. That's how good it is. Okay, one thing I will tell you with mascara is that you gotta be patient. You can't just apply two coats and be like, why is this not working? You have to wait apply another coat. Whenever you feel you need to stop, just stop there. Okay, but you need to let the first coat dry and then you need to apply the second coat. You need to wait for it to dry a little bit, then apply a third coat. That's how it actually shows the full effect of any mascara. Now on this side, I'm gonna use Lash Warrior. Almost gives the same effect, to be honest with you. It's the same. So depending on your price and your budget, you can pick your mascara, because I think a Flower Beauty is a teeny bit expensive. I think it's about like 800 bucks and this is 400. All right, so that is the eye. Super simple, amazingly easy to do and achieve. We're gonna move on to the rest of our face. Okay, so for bronzer, blush and highlight, I literally always am on the hunt for like one palette I can carry with me everywhere when I'm traveling, and it has to be good. And I didn't want to carry like bulky pieces, so I called for this Flower Beauty Lift and Sculpt Contouring Palette. It just came in before I started filming, so this is light to medium. They also have medium to dark, so depending on your skin tone. I called for light to medium. I hope this shows up on my skin, but this is slightly expensive, okay? But it's got all three, blush, bronzer and highlight. So we'll see if this works, then this works. Otherwise, I have two more bronzers here. And I have the L'Oreal bronzer. You've seen me use this a lot. This is the Glam Bronze. And guys, bronzers are a little bit expensive. So it's around 800 bucks, 1200 bucks. That's the price range. And I found good quality bronzers. I've used the LA Girl. I've used Makeup Revolution. Did not stick with me a lot. So this is what I boiled down to. So this is the one which I really, really like. And I think it's the perfect combination of cool and warm. I also called for this bronzer which came in just now. This is the L'Oreal again, back to bronze. It's in the shade number 2 Sunkiss. So since I know how this works, I'm gonna try this and I'm gonna try this, okay? Now you wanna pat. Oh, cool, cute, really nice application. Very, very nice. I don't like bronzers that are very powdery, so when you put it, it's like a splotch of bronzer. This is a very easy workable bronzer. Reminds me a lot of this bronzer, so I think it's like the same thing I got conned into buying. It's like the same formula. It looked different on the website, but it's basically the same formula and the same application, which is a great bronzer. You can build it up if you want it to be like really intense, and you can stop whenever you feel you're good. And I usually do not like contouring. I like bronzing, so I like bronzing and contouring. Just adding color to the face is what I use a bronzer for. Okay, that's what makes it look wearable. It's a great bronzer, love it. So yeah, totally yes for this. So my beginners, if you're doing your makeup, your bronzer or contour goes here, where there's a hollow. See this? That's where you want to add the color, okay? So, and your temples. Just go around once, just connect it once, that's it. Don't put a lot on your forehead. And of course your jawline, that's important. It's underneath your jawline. Okay, so now we're gonna move to the Flower Beauty palette. Please be good. Oh, baba. I should have ordered the dark only. Dark to, medium to dark would actually be the perfect one for me. This is way too light. Yeah, it's like barely showing up. I mean, I can build it, of course. Like you can kind of see the bronzer, but I have to build it way too much. Oh man, I should have ordered the medium to dark. It looked very dark on Nykaa, but medium to dark for everybody. Unless you're fairer than me, then this palette will be yours. Okay, I'm gonna find a way to make it work. But formula wise, great. I have no complaints. I think this is something I will travel with. Wow. For contouring, I'm gonna go back to this bronzer. Lays, if you wanna contour your nose, don't worry about it too much. Just like two, three, can you see the shadow? As compared to the side? That's it, just draw a straight line down. There's no rocket science in this. You have both the bridges of your nose you can see. Draw the lines closer if you want it narrower. Draw the lines wider if you want your natural looking nose. It all is an illusion. We're tricking the brain to think that your nose is sculpted by using a darker color on the sides of your nose, so it looks like a shadow. So makeup is like all tricks, you guys. Instant nose job without having to do much. See how it elongates the nose? And if you have a longer tip, that's coming out and you don't like that very much, you just put the bronzer underneath and it'll shorten the tip because it'll cast a shadow underneath that'll make it appear like a button nose. So when you put the bronzer underneath, it lifts the tip of your nose and it's an illusion of you having a very lifted nose. I actually really like this bronzer. I'm glad I bought it. It's very, very nice. So this color is very like Barbie pink, you know. It's got a very peppy, young, youthful feel to it. It's a very fresh blush. So for blush, babes, you will just tap very close to your nose, okay? Most people just put it here and let it be. Nope. Everything has to be connected. So you will just tap it here, and while you're tapping it close to your nose, you will bring it back into your contour. Back. It has to connect to your bronzer, okay? It cannot be blush, contour, highlight. That is the worst. So take your time with blush. I love loading my face with blush. I love blush. You don't have to go as crazy as me. Stop when you can. Wow, this is a beautiful blush. Loving this palette. So nice. It's so nice. It's really great. I also go here sometimes. Touch the temple. Few more blushes that I will recommend to you are the Maybelline Fit Me blushes. Very beautiful blushes. Beautiful, okay? And this is also very inexpensive. 440 rupees. This is the shade Wine. Love it. There's another shade called Rose. Beautiful. Another drugstore one is Colourbar. Love this brand and I love the products in this brand. So underrated. So any color in this. This is the Matte Illusion blush. This is in Timeless Rouge, but Fallen Leaves is one of my favorite shades. And these are matte blushes. They're very, very good. But yeah, I like this blush, so I'm gonna continue using the Flower Beauty one. Alright, beautiful, fresh looking face, no dark colors, leave it open. Beautiful, beautiful. I'm gonna take a finishing spray. I'm gonna spritz it all over because now we want to melt all the powders because we didn't use cream products. We used powder products and they can get cakey if you're dry skin. So you want to use a makeup finishing spray. I love the Smashbox one personally and the MAC Fix Plus. But since this is drugstore, the PAC Micro Finish Makeup Fixer is beautiful. The aerosol on this is really good. Like, it's like so breezy and beautiful. So yeah, that's why I recommend this one. And look at the quantity, it's so much. Drench yourself. And you'll instantly see that when it's drying, your powder products are like, they're like one soul now. And your makeup is just stuck to your skin so beautifully. And it's just a part of your body. It's not a mask, okay? It's a part of your body and it looks so good and juicy. You can go in with a beauty sponge if you feel there are some splotches, but with this you won't see any of it. Moving on to highlighter. This has been a long ass video, but such a useful video. Okay, moving on to highlighter, I have a few options here. So firstly, I have this highlighter that I want to try. For my girls with deeper skin tone than me, the Maybelline Master Chrome is a beautiful highlighter and I love this. This is in the shade Molten Gold. It's one of those highlighters that will not let you down. It's a blinding highlighter. So 100% recommend this. Then we have the Nykaa Glow Getter Highlighter Duo in Glitterati 02. They have, I think, 4 shades. Rose gold and blonde gold is what I found. Again, for deeper skin tones, this is very good. It's got a rosy one and a gold one as well. Beautiful formula. It'll apply very well. However, I'm gonna try this highlighter. I think it's gonna be too white for me, but let's see. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Okay. It is slightly on the white side, slightly on the silver side, but I can make it work because I can't see any streak when I'm looking forward, which is a good thing. So hell yeah to this palette, man. I can see myself travel just with this palette in case of an emergency. Oh, I don't want to carry too much. Boop, just take this with you. Finally, I found something. go for medium to dark. I think I'll buy a medium to dark. I want to see how it works on my skin. Okay, so I'm going to take beautiful formula on the highlighter. Drew Barrymore just killed it. Her makeup.
Oh my god, babe, honey. Stop. Okay, is this too much? It's a little bit much, okay.
Use my beauty sponge. Anything you want, any mistake you've made in your makeup, you want an instant eraser, this is your power tool. All you do is go over it and it subdues the highlight. That's the subdue version. Subdues it instantly. But I'm gonna use a tiny bit of Master Chrome to balance the silver out. So for highlighter, like I said, always it's the number 3. So a little bit on the temple, a little bit on the eye, and a little bit on the cheek, inner corner. It opens up the eye, makes it look like you're awake now. Bridge of the nose. Okay, so for lipstick, there are tons of lipsticks out there in the market. It's super personal, and also you have multiple options. If I had to go through my lipstick collection, we'll be sitting here for 3 days. I have so many lipsticks, but I narrowed it down to like the really, really simple lipstick. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about are lip liners. There are multiple options. NYX is great. Milani is really good with their lip liners. Nykaa is really good with their lip liners. So tons of options, but I have the K-Beauty lip liners there, which I think are really, really great because the shade range is phenomenal. They've got so many shades. That is why I like K-Beauty and I gravitated towards this, because it's got really, and it's a great formula. It's a formula that will stay on your lips. You can fill your lips in with this as well. So I'm gonna use this color today. This is the shade Fame. And for lipstick, again, I have the K-Beauty lipstick simply because of the shade range. They've got a lot of it, and I personally really like the formula when it comes to drugstore lipsticks. There's not many lipsticks I can think of off the top of my head which are my ride or die. I'm just holding a few, but they have a shit ton of colors that I could not even bring out here. So they've got red, plums, lots of nude options. So when you line your lips, you guys, of course, do it the way you want to. I love overlining my lips so that it looks a little fuller. You don't have to overline like crazy. All you gotta do is just go a little bit above your natural Cupid's bow and follow the natural lip line over here, okay? So that's how it's gonna give you that pout. And I always recommend using a darker color as a lip liner so it's actually visible and you can actually see the sculpting of your lips. I'm gonna like mix two lipsticks because I can't help myself. This is We Ours by K-Beauty. It's a beautiful peachy nude. And this is so matte, you guys. It's not even like, doesn't transfer. It's very matte and lasts you a long time. It is slightly drying, but I'm a matte chick, so I don't really care. I really love matte lipsticks. Apply a little bit of lip balm and you'll be good to go. Don't overthink this lipstick. There's Just Friends, but I love this color so much. Okay, let me apply like a little bit. Done! We're done, mommy. All right, guys, so this is the final result. Thank you so much for watching. I really, really hope this video helped you in so many ways, because I mean, I've discovered and I've missed a lot of products that I haven't been using for a long time and I need to get them back. But I love these and I 100% vouch for these products because these brands are outstanding. And if you trust Mals and if you really blindly trust what I do, just don't even overthink these products that I mentioned and just go for it and put it in your cart and place the order, and you can see it for yourself. I mean, look at the result, it's beautiful, okay? So yeah, I love you so much. I'm not gonna take so much time now. I'm gonna say bye to you. I love you and I will see you in my next video. The links to all these products will be down below, so don't forget to check them out. Take care and be safe. Bye.